Sampling error is what we have a 100-year-old body of statistical theory to deal with. It's a very simple idea that you want to learn about a whole population, but you don't get data from everyone in the population. You draw a sample, some kind of random sample, and then you try to make inference about the whole population from the sample. And that's what statistics texts are filled with. Sampling error goes away as sample size increases. If I only sample 5 people, I have a huge sampling error. If I sample 500, I have less sampling error. If I sample 5,000, 50,000, I have less and less sampling error. Non-response, though, is not a sampling error. Non-response is that some fraction of the people, let's take as an example, in the current population survey of the Census Bureau, over 20% of the people don't provide their wage on their primary job. Now, non-response of 20% does not go away by taking a larger sample. Because if I had 500 people, well, 20% of them don't respond. If I had 500,000 people, I'd still have 20% who don't respond. So there's always 20% who don't respond. And so that's not a sampling kind of problem. How you deal with non-sampling error, like particularly non-response, it requires assumptions. We were talking earlier about the role of assumptions. Well, the data's not there. Okay, so let's take a very particular thing, and this goes and touches on kind of some of the technical research that I do. Say you're interested in the poverty rate, and there's 20% of the population for whom you just don't get their income at all. Well, if you made no assumptions at all about the nature of non-response, there are two obvious extremes. It could be that all the non-respondents are very poor and are below the poverty rate, or it could be that none of the non-respondents are poor, they're all above the poverty rate. So the poverty rate, if you look at those two extremes, that none of the non-respondents are poor or all of the non-respondents are poor, that could be moved around quite a lot. That's a prime example of non-sampling error. What the Census Bureau does is for every one of those persons that doesn't report their income, they, what they call impute, or as they guess, put it another way, at what their missing data might be. And so if you and then they actually come out with a point value for the poverty rate, which is based 20% on the Census Bureau imputations or guesses as to the missing data. I am more concerned about non-sampling error, particularly non-response and also inaccuracies, because the statistical agencies basically suppress non-sampling error entirely now. The most technical of their documentation is to find a paragraph that says something like, of course there are many sources of non-sampling error, like non-response and misreporting and so on, and we should be aware of it. But no quantification whatsoever, no measurement. Since there's no measurement, the users of the data basically think it's not there. And I think the fact is that the non-sampling error may dwarf in importance the sampling error, because you can always get rid of sampling error by taking a large enough sample size. The non-sampling error, it just doesn't go away.